Hello! Now, I picked this up from Morrison's Bootlegger. Apple Root. Probably they used old Prohibition style in making this. 5.5% white grain spirit and. Seems legit. Look, these are the same people that brought you Lazy Jacks, as well as I think it was Krabby's and other famous alcoholic drinks. What it is with drink companies, they tend to see what's popular and then try to make it their own, like any company should try to do. But yeah, I think I paid about $160 for this, so it's not a complete loss. It'll just rather me drink in a bar where I'll probably pay more. I can drink it at home at my leisure and I'll be well. It's almost like the smell of apple chews. Yeah, apple chews and apple laces and all that kind of candy apple. So I'm not sure if it's a cider beer, but I'm going to go with mixed drink. Jack Daniels does it and Bacardi do it. But yeah, no head, really flat, slight fizz at the start, candy apple chew. Anyway, cheers. Quite thin on the body, not too harsh on the palate, not bad. What about again though? It's a one-off. I bought it out of curiosity, and I do like the way the branding is on the bottle. But for those who after apple. Or cider, you probably enjoy this. For those that are looking for a beer, you probably won't enjoy this. It's for those that like the flavoured drinks like Copperberg. I think they make that as well. But and those with Cordelier and that kind of stuff. Brewers, you know. So I'd lean more on the flavoured ciders than the flavoured beers. Would I recommend people buy it? No. Because it's forgettable. It doesn't give off any thing that would make you acute to go more into this range, which is what a drinks company should do. There's better drinks, flavored drinks out there, so it's just another one out for it. But yeah, it's cool to say I've had it, but there'll be like one person say, "Wow, that's interesting." Out of 100, you take care. Bye.